Guys, welcome to my fifth class of inverse Laplace transform. We discuss in my fourth class based on two standard result f of t by t and also the another one standard result n inverse of f of s by s is nothing but 0 to t f of t dt, and also we discuss what is it, what about that the function f of t by t is nothing but L inverse of s to infinity capital F of s dx. Now I am going to take a problem is in the form of t into f of t is nothing but L inverse of minus of first derivative of the given function F of s. Now here there is no restriction, I told in my previous class. The one of the problem is a standard problem, log of s plus 1 divided by s minus 1. I want to find out inverse transform of this, but you can't go for what I discussed in the previous class for second and standard result, because it's not easy to evaluate this integral value from h to infinity. Then the possibility is I go for this formula. Now see, if f of t is equal to L inverse of f of s, what is my f of s now? L inverse of what is my f of s? Log of s plus 1 divided by s minus 1. From this, what is my t into f of t is nothing but, from the formula what I written on the board, is nothing but L inverse of minus first derivative. See, better I have to go for derivative, then definitely after we also find the derivative of this log, is convert to one of the standard form of here inverse, then easily we get a solution in terms of t. Therefore, if the first derivative of f of s, what is f of s here? Log of s plus 1 divided by s minus 1, because this is given function is nothing but capital F of s. Now, you know that everyone how to find out derivative of this. First, you have to simplify, because this is in the form of log of a by b. Instead of finding directly, first you have to expand. What is log of a by b? Log a minus log b. Now after that, we are going to differentiate this by using linear property. Better to keep the negative sign outside. Derivative of log is 1 by s plus 1 into derivative of s with respect to s 1, but plus 0 because constant. Minus 1 by what is derivative of log? S minus 1 into derivative of s with respect to s 1. This is constant, therefore is 0. Now, see, after the first derivative, both the terms in a standard form. From the linear property, this can be written as L inverse of 1 by s plus 1 minus L inverse of 1 by s minus 1. We know that the formula, one of the standard formula, L inverse of 1 by s minus a, what's the formula we have? E power of a t. Therefore, in the first term, s plus 1 can also be written as s minus of minus 1. Therefore, what's the value? Minus e power of minus t, minus of e power of t. Are you clear? This is a way to find out inverse of which function? Log of s plus 1 by s minus 1. Are you clear why I am taking this? Because once you differentiate, directly is converted in which form? Standard form. Then easy to solve compared to second and third result. Are you clear? Now I am going to take another one of the standard function. Function is nothing but second one, cot inverse of s by 2. Yeah, this is my f of s. Yeah, if you want to find your inverse, we don't have any formula for inverse of cot inverse of s by 2. Suppose I have to differentiate that cot inverse, we convert it into what? Fraction. Then easy to solve by using any one of the standard result of inverse transform, Laplace transform. Therefore, what I am going to do here, if f of t equals L inverse of f of s, what is my f of s here? L inverse of cot inverse of s by 2. That implies, what is Still, I'm not finding that you know that because you can't write directly, we don't have any standard function corresponding to this. Therefore, that implies, suppose you differentiate, I told cot inverse is covered in the form of fraction. T into f of t is nothing but L inverse of minus into first derivative of this given function. What is function? Cot inverse of s by 2. Now, this is nothing but I keep the minus sign outside for my convenience. L inverse of what is derivative of cot inverse? Minus 1 by whatever that x square. What is x? S by 2 whole square plus 1 into derivative of s by 2 with respect to s. What we get? 1 by 2 into 1. Now I am going to repeat once again derivative of cot inverse. Actually, derivative of cot inverse x, what we are going to write usually? 1 by x minus 1 by x square plus 1. 1 by x square plus 1 into derivative of x is 1. But here instead of x, what you have? S by 2. What is derivative of s by 2 is? 1 by 2 into derivative of s with respect to s is 1. Now I take it minus and outside. What we get? Minus into minus plus. Now it is simplified by the L inverse of s square by 4. You take 4 is LCM. Therefore that 4 comes in numerator. 4 divided by s square plus 4. Because we already taken by LCM is what? 4. S square plus 4 divided by 4. That 4 comes in numerator into 1 by 2. 2 cancel with this. What's the remaining? Directly is in the standard form. This is nothing but L inverse of 2 by s square plus 4. This is nothing but what? Sine 2t. That t into f of t is nothing but what actually? Sine 2t. Therefore, what is my f of t now? F of t is nothing but, what is my f of t here is nothing but a sine 2t divided by t. This is a way to find out L inverse of cot inverse of s by 2. What's the answer we get? Sine 2t by t, because cot inverse of s by 2 is nothing but f of s. Once you apply inverse, what we get? F of t. I think from these two problems, it is very clear what's a more important, what's a more useful for the first standard result. Whenever it's not possible to take addition for the given function for f of s, once you differentiate, so in most of the cases convert to inverse of the standard form of inverse Laplace transform. Now observe the next problem, third problem, log of s square plus 1 divided by s into s plus 1. This is my f of s. Once you apply inverse transform, you can't find out the inverse of log. Once you remove the logs, definitely is convert to inverse of the standard form. Then I go for which one? T into f of t. Therefore, if f of t is nothing but L inverse of f of s, correct? Then t into f of t is nothing but what? L inverse of minus d by ds of f of s. What is my f of s here? F of s is nothing but minus of L inverse of first derivative of f of s. What is my f of s? Log of s square plus 1 divided by s into s plus 1. Don't find out derivative directly. First we expand this log. Minus L inverse of d by ds of s log. What is log of a by b? Log a minus log b. But here log b is nothing but what actually? Log of s into s plus 1. Again I go for log of a b. What is log of a b? Log a plus log b. Log a plus log b. I think everyone is clear. At a time you are using log of a by b and also log of a plus b. Now I have to differentiate by using linear property term by term. What is derivative of log? 1 by s square plus 1 into derivative of s square is 2s plus 0 because constant. And then I take minus sign minus. What is derivative of log? 1 by s into derivative of s with respect to s is 1 minus what is derivative of log is s plus 1 into derivative of s with respect to s is 1. From the linear property, what we are going to take inverse for the each of the term. Yes, while taking inverse and keep 2 outside because it's a constant, L inverse of s by s square plus 1 minus L inverse of 1 by s. Yes, minus L inverse of what? 1 by s plus 1. 1 by s plus 1. Now, I take minus sign inside. Minus 2 into what is this? This is a standard function. L inverse of s by s square plus 1 is nothing but cos t. A is 1 here. Minus, minus e to minus is plus. What is L inverse of 1 by s is 1. Minus e to minus plus. What is L inverse of this is what? E power of s plus 1 can be written as s minus of minus 1. What we get actually? E power of minus 2. Yeah. See how easily I have to evaluate the given function if opposite log of s square plus 1 divided by s into s plus 1. I think you are clear this how to solve. I solved totally in this class 3 problems based on the standard function. What's the standard function here? T into f of t is nothing but L inverse of the minus of first derivative of capital F of s. Here there is no restriction. Once you differentiate, suppose you call the standard form, easily we get what is inverse of function compared to the second and third result. Now this is a way to solve the problem using the first, second and third result. Now, I think it's clear how to solve by using them. Keep in mind, if you want to go for this formula, we have to differentiate first. After the differentiate, apply term by term form, linear property for you, find out the derivative. I think compared to integration, differentiation is easy, most of the students. I'm going to refer better to go for this method compared to other method. But some cases, second result you raise very quickly, you already observed in the my previous classes. Thank you very much for listening my talk. If suppose you like my video, please tell like button and also subscribe my channel. Thank you.